In this video, we are going to learn how to use our in-app payment processing feature. We will cover the different places you can post payments using this feature and how to track and view payments. Users with the patient or insurance payment permission are able to post payments using this feature. Let's get started. You can use in-app credit card processing from the appointment scheduler, the claim section, and the payment section. Let's begin with how to process payments through the scheduler. At check-in, you can efficiently collect patient payments from the appointment before any charge or claim has been created. Locate the patient's appointment, right-click, and select Edit Appointment. Click the Payment tab and enter your payment information, such as the payment amount, received date, and payment type. Then, select Credit Card as the source. Use the drop-down menu to select the merchant account that the payment should be sent to. Click into the card number field and swipe the patient's credit card in the card reader. Then, click Save. The payment funds will be sent to your merchant bank account and saved within CMD automatically. Remember, if you post a payment through the scheduler, an account credit will be created because no service has been rendered. Select the provider and office this credit should be associated with, then save. When you are ready to apply this credit to a charge, head over to the Apply Credit screen. The second place to post payments is from the claim section. This method is useful when creating a claim while the patient is still in the office. This way, you can post the payment directly to a charge before sending the claim to your payer. Open the claim for the patient, expand the payment side panel, select Post New Payment to the Claim, enter the payment information, then click Save. The last section we will cover is the post screen under the payment section. This is the most common method to post patient payments. Payments made from this screen can be added as account credits and, if a claim exists, posted directly to a charge. To start, select the patient making the payment, then enter the payment info. Click Credit Account to post the payment as an account credit, or select Apply Automatically or Manually to post the payment to a charge or payment plan. Now, let's review how you can track and view those payments from the Patient's Activity screen and the Report screen. The Activity screen provides you with a quick view of any payments the patient has made. To start, open a patient record, then click Activity. Expand the Payment History section to view all the payments this patient has made. Payments made using in-app payment processing will contain an authorization number. The Applied To column will show you if the payment created an account credit or for which claim the payment was applied towards. Payments made through the payment portal will be recognized as an online payment in the Type column. There are two standard reports that are designed to help you track patient payments. Users with the report permission will be able to run and view the reports associated with in-app payment processing. The daily, monthly, charges and debits report breaks down all of the payment and charges within a given time, while the merchant payments report reflects payments made using in-app payment processing. It will also show you if the payment was made online through the patient portal or within the application. Now that you know how to post and view payments, log in and start collecting and managing payments faster than ever before. For step-by-step directions, FAQs, and other how-to videos on the payment section, visit our Knowledge Center at help.collaboratemd.com. Thanks for watching.